So today when you buy a printer, it's a lot different than it was years ago. We all have Wi-Fi networks and a lot of printers today have Wi-Fi connections. So you're very quickly and easily hooking your printer up to your entire network. If you've got a large family and you have several printers and computers, it can be very confusing. When you go to print something, you may see several printers in the print list. I only see one here. It's all I've got. But you could easily see several and they could be from the same manufacturer and even have similar names. So it could be confusing as to which one you're printing to. So fortunately, you can name your printers. The place you do that is in System Preferences. So go to System Preferences, Printers and Scanners. And here you'll find a list of your printers on the left. And you've probably been here before, maybe when you've added a new printer or something. And here you can see my printer. It's not even online, but that's not going to change the fact that I can name it. So I'm going to, in order to name it, simply control click on it. And you can see I've got several options. One is set the default printer, so I can set my default printer for my computer here. But I can also rename the printer. So if I rename it, something I'll remember and I'll know that this is the one that I want to go to. Now you can see the name is changed there. When I switch back to text edit here and I go to print, you can see I get that printer there named. So I didn't even have to have it online. It's not actually telling the printer you've got a new name. It's just renaming the printer here in my system. Now you should know that while this name is changed for this user on this computer, and it seems to change for the other users on this computer as well, it's not going to change the name, of course, for other Macs on your network because it's not actually changing the name of the printer itself. It's just changing kind of the nickname that this computer calls it. So you can call it one thing and somebody on another computer in your household can call it something different if they want, which can actually be a useful feature.